Miami will go to the locker room, down by 14, and Virginia Tech will get the ball to start the third quarter.
Let's go! Push them in!
I didn't really say too much at halftime, and I just told them, really, you know, you're down 21-7 in Blacksburg. That's pretty hostile territory right now.
This is about life and who you are as individuals and who we are as a team right here. Let's go out there one play at a time and just chop away. So just go one play at a time. Just promise me you're going to go one play at a time. One play at a time. Let's go
down, man. Break it down.
Let's go. Hey, man, I got one word for y'all, man.
It's really not about the game anymore. It's about life and how you're going to respond. And then I kind of stepped back hoping that someone would take the lead.
Halftime in the locker room, you know, I just, you know, Coach Golden spoke. You know, all the guys gathered up to go back and take the field. I just simply said one word. I said, don't come out here if you don't believe. If you don't believe in yourself, you don't believe in the team that we come out here with this victory, with this W, don't come out here, don't take the field no more.
If you don't believe, don't go back out there, man. Believe on three. One, two, three.
Believe.
Rush out.
I mean, that was it. I was like, okay, we are going to be fine because the kids have never heard that from Brandon. And I said, man, we are going to give these guys hell in the second half. I probably had every reason in the book not to be confident, but I had a real inner confidence after hearing Brandon bring the team together and say and challenged him to believe in each other and to keep fighting. It was great.
Coach Golden been pressuring me about stepping up my leadership and being a leader. I just felt I had to get that out of my system because I wanted a W.
I've been here 10 months and we haven't got him to speak in front of the team one time. And then he steps up in the midst of what was basically a turkey shoot going on outside. And said, give me the flag. I'm gonna carry it.
I got emotional that we was down 21-7. Things weren't clicking.
Leadership cannot occur, and I'm convinced of it, without crisis. It meant a lot. It meant a lot to our team, I promise you that.
We took that to heart, and the offense, we started clicking, and we tried to put points on the scoreboard so we could get back in the game.
Third and four, Harris from the shotgun, looking left, throwing. Sideline caught by Benjamin, down the sideline. He's got one man to beat at the 20, 15, 10, 5. Travis Benjamin will go all the way for a Miami touchdown.
We got the exact look we wanted. The corner jumped the out route to Allen, and then the safety tried to make a break on the ball that we threw to, you know, Travis, and we wound up being able to hit the big play on it.
That all falls back on the preparation with Coach Fish. He told us that this team is a big gambling team. They like to jump routes, and so that's just proper preparation.
Once we were down by 14, I figured they thought they had the game sealed.
Any team, you know, they consider that they get pretty comfortable, you know, and feel like, you know, they have us out of there. But, you know, we believe, you know, we just sticking to the process.
Yeah, we'll keep going with it.
We just got done. We just hit a 77-yard touchdown pass. It was 21-14. They got the ball back. They went down, and they kicked the field goal to make it 24-14.
Miami's got a first and goal at the four. Streeter goes wide left.
We went down and scored a touchdown to make it 24-21.
Harris waits for the snap. Fade route, far corner. Tommy Streeter, he has got it for a touchdown! Harris, the Tommy Streeter. Ja'Cory strikes for the third time today. And Miami is in this ball game.
Jed's been doing a great job with Ja'Cory, and Ja'Cory's doing an excellent job trusting. I think he's confident in himself, and I think more importantly, he's trusting his teammates.
It's Virginia Tech 24, Miami 21.
He scored, you know, closed down that lead, you know, 24-21. Then they hit us with, you know, another quick touchdown.
He's throwing the ball deep down the field. Has Boykin out there. Got him at the 20, at the 15. Touchdown, Virginia Tech.
We on the sideline, we're like, you know, we get to go back in and do it again. It was just like, yeah, you know, it's a challenge. You know, I don't think I was excited that they scored, but I was excited that I can get back on the field and then score again, you know, score again.
We knew as an offense that we had to execute, and we were having fun at the time. So just going out the field and being able to complete passes and running was just fun to us. So we wanted to go back on the field.
We just came together, making big plays. The coaches, all they could do is just call the plays, and we got to execute.
Nothing there. Cuts back at the 5-yard line. Gets a block. Looks for another one. He's across the 20. Breaks a tackle at the 30. He's at the 35. He's at the 45-yard line. He's finally dragged down at the 47-yard line.
I think that the biggest thing is we found ways to move the football, and no matter the score, no matter the situation, we felt as if we were going to score every time we touched it.
It was no discouragement or nothing. You know, I couldn't see that. You know, I didn't see guys moping or anything. Everybody was just, you know, let's go, you know what I'm saying? Really believing in what, you know, we're trying to do. you know, and that was just run the ball.
I wasn't discouraged at all because I knew we was going to go out and execute and just play Hurricane football.
On first down, handoff, up the middle to the 40-yard line, to the 35, Miller to the 30, breaks another tackle down to the 25 and still going, moving the pile.
I knew what he was capable of, Lamar, but I didn't know he was going to explode like that in the second half.
Lamar averaged 9 yards a carry. Michael averaged 6.5 yards a carry.
First down handoff for James on the cutback. He's got room at the 20. He's down to the 15-yard line, lacerating the defense.
That made my job easy. Like, I know what type of backs you got in the backfield, that I can't miss my block.
The most rewarding part about it is, you know, seeing your back, you know, 10, 20 yards in front of you, you know, that just keeps you energized. You just want to keep on doing it. You know, it was fun.
So we got to a point where we ran it, and as I was watching the outside during each run, every time it became less and less people out there.
We get down there to the goal line, I mean, to in the red zone. You know, coach calls the trick play with Dorsett.
When he called the play, I read it in the huddle, and I said, hold on, I think it's wrong. And I looked to the sideline, I said, coach, you sure this? I said, you sure? And I signaled the number back to him, he signaled it back to me, and I was like, I said, guys, yeah, he's sure about this play. I said, let's run it, let's get it in.
Yeah, I didn't even think anything of it. We practiced it for the last month. We've had it in every week for every game. And why not call it?
Second and one. Quick screen pass. It's going to be a throw by Dorsett to the end zone for Miller. He dives. He's got it. Touchdown, Miami.
I was calling Dorsett for the ball. I was telling Dorsett throw it to me because I felt like I was open. When I seen Lamar, and he threw the ball, I was like, yeah, this is a touchdown. Lamar made a great adjustment.
Dorsett to Lamar Miller for a touchdown, and they just hoodwinked Virginia Tech.
I knew he trusted Dorsett to throw that pass because in practice, we do it all the time.
I didn't mind that Phillip was a freshman. I didn't think anything of it. He's a good arm. He throws the ball well, and we hit a big play.
They just relaxed, finally. They just relaxed and played, and they enjoyed the battle. I keep talking to them about enjoying the battle, and just to watch the O-line, and it's not all perfect. You go back and watch the tape, it's not all perfect, but they were flying around and playing with energy.
On first down, it's a run for Miller. He's got a hole across the 35. Mm. He gets a block at the 30. 25, Miller to the 20, and right down at the 18.
It was a three-point game. It was 31-28. We were losing.
We had first and goal at the 6, but we got a couple penalties that pushed us back.
Holding number 5 of the offense is accepted. 10-yard penalty.
Another penalty. 15 yards.
Could be a personal foul against Miami.
It's a 15-yard penalty.
It's a 15-yard penalty. And now you've got a second and goal. They're self-destructing. They had the ball at the 6-yard line.
Nobody wanted to watch the scoreboard, but I looked up and I saw the scoreboard said second and 30 on the goal. Second and 30, the goal to go. And I was like, what, Horn? It's second and 30?
If I ever felt like it was a time in that game where we needed to panic, it was when it was second and 30. We're 3 points down, trying to, you know, close the lead in the game.
I think that one word statement, believe, just held everybody poised, and the leadership on the field at the time just held everybody poised. I just, you know, just execute the play call.
The crowd was charged up. There was a penalty, could be discouraging, but in the end, it was that focusing on this play mentality.
And it was just like, man, let's go, you know? Let's go, man. And that was it. Nothing else.
Here's a handoff for Lamar Miller, right side. He breaks right to 20, 15, 10, 5. Lamar Miller, touchdown! Touchdown, Miami! Lamar Miller, 30 yards for the go-ahead score.
Lamar Miller runs it in for a touchdown.
I didn't hear the crowd. That's what I didn't hear. I knew we had hushed the crowd. It just felt good. I could have played 30 more minutes of that game.
They actually played for each other. You know, they were playing for something outside of themselves. And man, we have not had that here since I've been here.
I say if we hadn't gone through a lot of things that we have gone through this year, then maybe we probably would have been easy for a lot of guys to get discouraged and quit at that point in time. But I think this team has been battle-tested with a lot of things.
Virginia Tech needs a touchdown to win it. 35-31, 2:46 to go.
We knew we had left, a few minutes on the clock for Virginia Tech's offense to do something.
Breaks a tackle to 25, down to the 23.
You hear the fans and crowd roaring. You gonna look on the field, look at the scoreboard to see what's going on, like this can't be happening.
You know, you look up and it's 4th and 1 on our red zone. You just don't know what to expect.
4th and 1, you may never get that situation to end the game right there again. That's a chance to end the game.
He's going to keep it in the ring, draw up the middle, and he's going to score for a touchdown.
You know, it's a touchdown. It's like, wow, you know. You don't expect that.
All over in Blacksburg, Virginia. Hokies 38, Miami 35.
It was heartbreak, you know. Heartbreak.
Initially, I was trying to gain my composure before I spoke to them. As more players came into the locker room, I could see just how heartbroken they were.
I don't care how masculine or however you feel, you get choked up, you know. Failure's not an easy thing to handle, especially when you work so hard.
It was just disbelief. You know, a lot of us didn't believe that we were gonna lose that game.
You can tell when a team really invests in a game. Physically and mentally and emotionally, and so I clearly knew at that point that that they really invested in it and really believed and wanted it badly.
All right, the first thing I want to tell you is how proud I am of you. Okay, there are no moral victories. You guys know that. There are no moral victories. Okay, there are no moral victories. But listen to what I'm telling you. Okay. You're down 21-7 in the toughest environment you'll face. Maybe some of you, the toughest environment you'll face in your life. Okay? And you hung together. We had leadership. We fought back. All right? And we really should have won the game. I think you guys know that. Okay? So the first thing I want to tell you is I'm really proud of you guys for staying together. Because that is not just the fact that we stayed together here on October 8th, right? We built that over the last 10 months, okay?
I'm hoping we can carry that forward because it just took one guy with ability, talent, status, and the requisite skills to step up at that one poignant moment and lay it on the line. And he just basically said, hey, it's okay, guys. We're gonna stay together and we're just gonna do our thing.
And Kane's on three, Kane's on three. One, two, three. Kane.